Hi, welcome to Math with Miss B. Like I usually say in all my notes, you need, in all my notes, in all my videos, you need some paper. You need to be taking some notes. Why do you need to take some notes? Because I already know what I'm doing. We want to make sure you know what you're doing. All right.
Math with Miss B. Math with Miss B. There's a thousand other places that you'd rather be. But you're watching Math with Miss B.
All right. What you always want to know is that our slope formula is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Number one, identify point one. Number two, identify point two. Number three, count the rise. Number four, count the run. Number five, double check your sign. Double check your sign. Okay, let's go. So I have 2 points on the graph. I have point one and I have point two. All right, we're gonna count our rise. So your rise is up and down, okay? So from point one, doop, 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 ooh, look at us. I bounced 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. And then I went down. So you wanna pay attention to which direction that you went. So then I'm gonna run over. I ran over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces and I went to the right. Remember, when you go to the right, that's my run and right is positive. So that's why it's a green arrow. So the rise went down, that's negative arrow. And then my run went to the right and that's green because it's a positive arrow, okay? So my slope is -4/6. But you remember, when you have fractions, you always wanna make sure that you simplify your fractions. So when I simplify them, I can simplify both of those by 2 and I'm gonna get -2/3 as my slope. Why did I choose -2/3? Well, the rise, 4 was negative, so that's why I made sure I put a negative on that. So my entire slope becomes negative. Now I can double check that by using the formula. y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So point one is -3, 6, and then point two is 3, 2. So if I plug them into the formula, y2, 2 minus y1, 6 over x2, 3 minus x1, -3, and I simplify, I would still get -4/6 equals -2/3. So you can choose which one you want to do, depending on your teacher, if your teacher allows you to, and you will still get the same answer. Look at that. All right, sorry, that's example number one, out of 6. Okay, so now let's say these are my next 2 points. You see those pink dots on the screen? We wanna count our rise and then we wanna count our run. So first of all, I'm gonna count my rise. You see that? Boom, boom, that was 2. And which direction did I go? I went up. And then I'm gonna do my run. Wow, lots of jumps there, 11 spaces. That was my run. So 2/11 is my slope. Can I simplify that? Nah, it's already simplified. So this is my formula. I can double check myself. Again, I only have to double check myself if I want to, right? Using the formula. But if I counted, look, both of my arrows are green, up to the right. Both my arrows are green, both numbers are positive. So I don't need to double check my signs because positive, positive, right? But I'm gonna double check using the formula. My first point was -8, 1. My second point was 3, 1. So when I do y2, 1 minus y1, -1 over x2, 3 minus -8. When I simplify, I would still get the same thing. I went past that a little too quick, but it's fine. Okay. Okay, so we have our next 2 points. We gotta count our rise. Do, do, do. So rose 3, but we went down, so that's a negative. And then doop, doop, ran over 2. That's also negative. Ooh, negative over negative. What kind of slope is that? Well, if you look in the handy dandy little box, you can tell that a negative over a negative is a positive slope. Okay, and we can double check that using our wonderful formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, knowing that the first point is 8, 6, and the second point is 6, 3. It doesn't matter which point you label as point number one and point number two. Anyway, so we're gonna do y2, which is 3, minus 6, which is y1, over x2, which is 6, minus x1, which is 8. So we're gonna get negative 3 over negative 2. And if you pay attention to our arrows, notice that both of our arrows were red, which means they were negative. But we know that a negative over a negative turns out to be positive 3 over 2. So we double checked our answer and it was still right. All right, example number 4. All right, we're gonna count our rise. Ooh, lots of rising happening over here. All right, 11 spaces. We're going up. And then our run. 5. And we're going that way. Great. So I have 11 over negative 5. We could also just say negative 11 fifths. It's fine. Okay? We can double check. I put a negative on that 5 because my arrow was negative. Okay? Notice our rise and then our run. If I look in the handy dandy little box over there, my rise, green, and run red is going to give me a negative slope. Anyway, point number 1 is 1, 4. Point number 2 is 6, -7. When I plug them into the formula, -7 - 4 / 6 - 1, I'm gonna get -11/5, or just -11/5. Same thing. All right, we're gonna go to example number 5. All right, I have 2 points, and they are horizontal to each other. Oh my goodness. So guess what? Do I have a rise? Can I go up or down here? No, I cannot. All I can do is run. So that means my rise is 0. My run, however, is 10. So 0 over 10 equals 0. I can double check the formula if I want to. Point 1, point 2. -7 - -7, 6 - -4. I'm gonna get 0 because -7 turns into a positive. So -7 + 7, positive. So that's a 0. They cancel each other out on the top. And then on the bottom, I'm left with 10, but still 0 over 10 is still gonna be 0. Anytime I have a horizontal line, 2 points, horizontal to each other, level, okay? That is going to be a 0 slope. Remember that. Okay, so now I have slide 8 out of 8. This is example number 6. Sorry. Now I have 2 points that are on top of each other, so they're vertical, okay? So I definitely have a rise here, and it's 7. But do I have a run, y'all? I ain't got no run. 0 is my run. 0. So guess what that's going to be? 7/0. Anytime I have a 0 on the bottom, I call that undefined. 0 on the bottom, undefined. Period, poo. I could double check the formula. Same thing's going to happen. Point 1, -4. -7, point 2, -4, 0, 0 - -7, -4 - -4, 7/0. Anytime there's a 0 on the bottom, the answer is undefined. If the 0 is on the top, then the answer is 0. You should write that down in your notes, this special, and put a little asterisk by there, highlight it, make sure you remember that, okay? As I always say, you should go back through the video, see if you could do the problems without my help. And if not, I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.